Hey everyone, in today's video, we're going to be talking about the button layout for the WEEBILL 2. Let's start off with the axes and axis locks. On this gimbal, we have three different axes. We have the tilt, the pan, and the roll. Each of these axes have their own individual lock. This lock will help with transportation and when balancing and setting up your WEEBILL 2 gimbal. Each lock can be engaged simply by flipping it with your finger. Now that we covered the axes and the axis lock, let's talk about the rest of the gimbal. On the top portion of the gimbal, you will have access to the quick release plate and quick release system. This is where we're going to be mounting our camera. Here is the tensioner for the quick release plate. You will need to unlock the tensioner and press down on the safety release notch in order to slide out the quick release plate. It's also important to note that we have additional accessories that attach to the quick release plate, such as the lens support bracket and the camera backing plate. This camera backing plate, or the riser plate, will lift up the camera so that way you can attach larger lenses. To attach the riser plate, simply grab the necessary screws. Notice how they are different sizes. The thinner screw will be the one that attaches directly to your camera. Now for this video, I'll just simply be showing you how to attach the riser plate to the quick release plate. Grab the two other screws that come in your kit and screw it into the quick release plate. Once two screws are in the quick release plate, then you can attach the riser plate. Make sure everything is good and tight. Next, grab your lens support bracket and use the included thumb screw to screw it onto the front of the quick release plate. Now let's talk about the other accessories that may come with your WEEBILL 2, depending on the package that you get. For example, here's the tripod. This will attach via the 1/4-20 inch port on the bottom of the WEEBILL 2. The sling arm handle will attach using a bracket that is screwed on to the upper portion of the WEEBILL 2. You can use a flathead screwdriver to tighten this up. Once it's attached to the WEEBILL 2, you can slide on the sling arm handle easily until it locks into place. There's also a tensioner on the side that will lock the handle in place. I also recommend switching on the security lock on the side, which gives you an extra level of protection and it keeps the handle from slipping. Also, for your convenience, we have a mini rosette mount with a 1/4-20 inch mount built inside. This will allow you to attach any other accessory that you would like. On the left side of the gimbal, you will be able to access the power button, photo and video button, the joystick, control wheel, mode switcher, and on the front of the gimbal, you will have access to the trigger button. To turn on the gimbal, hold down the power button until all LEDs light up. The LEDs also symbolize the power indicator for the battery. Four lights are fully charged, and one light means that you are at 25% power. On the bottom of the WEEBILL 2 gimbal, you will have a USB-C port, which will enable you to charge the gimbal. It will also allow you to update and install firmware when you're using your computer. To open the LCD screen, simply slide it over to the left. Also, swivel the screen up approximately 45 degrees and it will lock into place. Please do not force the LCD screen if it locks into place, otherwise you may break it. And it also slides out in one direction, not both directions. In another tutorial video, I'll show you how to fully assemble and balance your gimbal ready for shooting. It's important to understand where each of the adjustments and latches are on each of the axes of this gimbal. For example, we have the horizontal or roll adjustment latch right next to the quick release system. You can find it directly under it. This will move the whole adjustment plate either to the left or to the right. To the right of the quick release system, you have a thumb screw which will give you more adjustments for the tilt axis. Again, I will show you how to properly balance your gimbal in another tutorial video. And lastly, we have the pan adjustment latch. When this tensioner is released, you will be able to move the pan arm either forward or backward. And lastly, the digital ports that are used to hook up your AI transmitter and your follow focus system. You can find two ports in the front of the gimbal right next to the tilt motor and one directly behind it. Also, don't forget about the charging port on the bottom of the WEEBILL 2, which will also allow you to update the firmware. And that just about does it for the rundown of the buttons and overall layout of the WEEBILL 2 gimbal. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in another tutorial video.